my dear children, I am Anupama and I welcome you to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School channel. I am here to teach you a poem in English for grade 8, which is poem number 3, McCurdy the Mystery Cat. I want everyone to open your textbook, Honeydew textbook, page number 50, and I want all my dear children to be with pen or pencil in the hand because I am going to read the poem and explain you the difficult word meaning along with that. So let's begin with this new very interesting poem, that is McCurdy the Mystery Cat, which is written by T.S. Eliot, whose name is Thomas Eastern Eliot. He was a poet, he was an essayist, he was a publisher, playwright, literary critic, as well as an editor. My dear children, he has even won a Nobel Prize in the year 1948. Now this poem which we are going to understand, it's an interesting poem which tells something about the cat. So this poem, T.S. Eliot has written in his one of the book named Practical Cat, and then this is the only book which he has written for the younger generation or younger audience. So let's see what T.S. Eliot wants to tell about the cat, what name, what nickname he has given to this animal. McCurdy is the name of the cat, but though here this cat McCurdy is a cat, but he is rather portrayed or despised as a hardcore criminal. Hardcore criminal means what? The one who does crime, but for the people, for the police, it's very difficult for the police or squad to catch hold of McCurdy. He is that much mysterious, that means he is very strange, he is unknown to anyone. He yes does the crime, but when the police reaches at this place, it's very difficult for the police to catch hold of him. So here the poet has tried to give in all the minute details of his behavior, his action, his appearance. What does he do? Why it's difficult for the police to catch hold of him? How does he exactly look? How we are going to recognize this mystery cat? Everything is given in the detail. So because of this mystery or because of this action, it reminds me, my dear children, one of the dialogue from the movie Dawn, that Dawn ko pakadna mushkil hi nahi, but namumkin hai. So why it is like that? Let's find it out, everything in detail. So this is a fictional character, rather an imaginary character, which has been portrayed by T.S. Eliot, the poet of this poem. So I'm going to read first the outline of the poem. Do you have a pet cat? So there's been question been asked to the students that do you have a pet as a cat? Have you ever noticed? Noticed means have you ever come across or found anything mysterious about it? Mysterious means what? Something hidden, something which is not known, something you never understand. It is not easy to say whether every cat is a mystery, but McCurdy is one for sure. So the poet says it's not necessary that all the cats are like McCurdy, but McCurdy is something, he is of one. For sure. What is it that makes him a perfect mystery cat? Read the poem and find out. So the poet says that why it is said McCurdy is McCurdy of his own kind. There is no cat like McCurdy. If you really want to know this, read the poem and understand everything. So I hope that everybody is paying attention. I want pen or pencil in the hand. Open page number 50 in your Honeydew textbook, my dear children. I'm going to read the poem aloud first, make you understand the difficult word meaning. You are going to write everything in your textbook, and then I'm going to explain the poem stanza wise. So let's begin. First, I'll read the poem aloud. Pay attention and look with all those pronunciations. McCurdy is a mystery cat. That means McCurdy is a mystery cat. He is called the hidden power. He is the master criminal who can defy the law. He is the bafflement of Scotland Yard. the flying squads despair. For when they reach the scene of crime, McCavity is not there. McCavity, McCavity, there is no one like McCavity. He's broken everywhere, every human law. He breaks the law of gravity. His powers of levitation would make a fakir stare, and when you reach the scene of crime, McCavity is not there. You may seek him in the basement, you may look up in the air, but I tell you once and once again, McCavity is not there. McCavity is a ginger cat. He is very tall and thin. You'd know him if you saw him, for his eyes are sunken in. His brow is deeply lined with thought. His head is highly domed. His coat is dusty from neglect. His whiskers are uncombed. He sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. And when you think he's half asleep, he is always wide awake. McCavity, McCavity, there's no one like McCavity. For he is a finned in feline shape, a monster of depravity. You may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square. But when a crime's discovered, then McCavity is not there. T.S. Eliot, that is Thomas Stearns Eliot. So my dear children, now let's see everything in detail about this cat, why he is said as mystery cat, and then what is he exactly doing in this poem. I want everybody's attention. McCavity is a mystery cat. Underline the word mystery. Mystery means hidden, which is not known. Nobody cannot understand who is he, how is he, what does he do, and where does he finally escape after doing a crime. So he is unknown to everyone. He is that he, apostrophe S means what he is. He is called the hidden pow. Hidden means something unknown, which is very secret. What is meant by pow? Pow is nothing but the foot of an animal. So here, hidden pow is one more nickname given by T.S. Eliot to this McCavity, who is the mystery cat. So how he is? He is like a hidden pow. He is unknown to anyone. When he comes, when he goes, nobody knows that. So the reason he is a hidden pow, that's a nickname given by the poet. Then he says, for he is the master criminal who can defy the law. Master means the one who is very expert in doing any sort of kind or a work. Criminal, that means who doesn't follow the laws. Okay, who is criminal, who is legal offender, who doesn't obey the law, criminal. Who can defy means who can disobey the law. He is the bafflement of Scotland Yard, the flying squad's despair. He is the bafflement. Bafflement means he is the puzzle or he is the confusion. To whom? To the Scotland Yard. Who is Scotland Yard, my dears? You can write the headquarters of London Police Force. Okay. And then as well as the flying squad's despair. Flying squad's despair means what? People, you know, the police force, the group of people, those who are, you know, quickly they run to the place where it's very emergency or where the crime takes place. Okay, so he is even the puzzle for this flying squad, and these people are left with what? Despair. Despair means what? Disappoint or sadness. Disappointment. For when they reach the scene of crime, McCavity is not there. So my dear children, let's understand this first stanza, what T.S. Eliot wants to say, that McCavity is like a hidden power. He has got some mystery with him. Why it is? Because what he does, that he commits the crime. He commits a crime, he is such a master, he is such expert doing any of the crime, that he does everything, and runs away from that place. And when the Scotland Yard, when the police of the London, when they reach to that place, they are left in the puzzle, they are left in the confusion that something has happened wrong, and who has done this, how it has been done, and then who is the person behind this crime. So it's so difficult for even the London police to find this fellow, as well as the flying squad. Flying squad is a group of people, those are very active and they are on their toe all the time, that whenever there is a call for the emergency, they reach that place immediately to find the criminal. But even for them, it's a mystery for them. They are even left in a puzzle, they are left in surprise, that because McVitie has done everything, but nobody knows how it has happened and where's the criminal. And then he says, for when they reach the scene, they means what? Either the Scotland Yard, that means the London police, or the flying squad, those who are all the time on their toe, they are all the time ready in an emergency case to reach that place. Even they are left in puzzle, they are left in confusion. They don't know, they don't understand that who has done this, how it has happened, and how the criminal is, you know, able to escape or run away from that place. So he says, McCavity, McCavity, there is no one like McCavity. This statement says that he is one of his kind. There is no replacement for McCavity. He is the unique sort of animal that is mysterious. Nobody is like McCavity, he says. He has broken every human law. Human law means what, my dear children? The law which we people follow, which we people obey, isn't it? So here the poet says that how he is so expert, he is so expert doing in his things done, or he is such a criminal that even he has disobeyed, he has crossed all the boundaries of the laws, he has disobeyed the law, whatever the human laws have been done, he has crossed all those laws. And then what he says, he breaks the law of gravity. Law of gravity means what? We people are all the time grounded on the floor, isn't it? So this fellow, especially talking about McCarty, if anybody who is trying to run behind him or who is trying to catch hold of him, so he is all the, you know, sudden he escapes from that place, or even the law of gravity is not applicable for this fellow. So he is that quick, he is that expert, that we are left in amazement. He disobeys all the human laws that those are being prepared. And then his powers of levitation would make a fakir stare. Powers of levitation, levitation, underline that word. Levitation means nothing but floating in air without any support. So if, my dear children, if you have seen any of the movie where there are a lot of actions, there is a lot of fight, and then you know you can see some martial arts, and when there are, you know, different characters, those who are involved in, you know, playing that martial art, you can see that they have that art in such a way that sometimes they lift their body in the air, you know, or they got with some stunts and all. So here also, this is such an imaginary character. Eliot has written the poem so beautifully that it takes us in the imaginary world to imagine this mysterious cat McVitie, that he has done some crimes, he has offended some law, and then he is trying to run away from that situation, and how he runs, that he doesn't obey any human laws, rather the law of gravity is also not applicable for him, as well as he is blessed with some powers. What sort of powers? That is levitation. That means all of sudden, if somebody comes across McVitie and if they try to catch hold of him, he immediately vanishes or disappears in the air. That is what, you know, floating in the air without any support. We have seen in that in some movies also, isn't it? So this is what the power of levitation is, and this power of levitation even leaves the fakir. Who is fakir? Fakir is nothing, my dear children, a person who is sent, who doesn't have any belongings, who doesn't have his own life. He leads a life very lonely, dedicated to God, we can say. So even for fakir also, when they come across MacVittie, and if they see MacVittie with the power of this levitation, flying in the air, floating in the air, all of a sudden vanishing in the air, so even for saint also, they are surprised to see that how come, how it is possible that MacVittie can do all these things. He is blessed with all these powers. So this is what we can see, that he, the surprising or powerful skills which he is possessed with, which he has with him. And so the reason we can see that he is criminal, he is expert in doing all these things. And then, and when you reach the scene of crime, MacVittie is not there, obviously. So the law of gravity, this law is not applicable for this fellow, as well as is having the power of levitation to run away or to escape in the air. So the reason it is really not possible to the people to, when they reach at the crime scene of the crime or the place where the crime has taken place, and for them it is not possible to catch hold of this criminal, because once the crime has done, it's taken place, but MacVittie is not at that place. Then let's move further. You may seek him in the basement, you may look up in the air. Underline the word seek. Seek means to search or to find. Him in the basement. Basement is nothing but an area, an underground area, we can say. As well as you may look up in the air. Look up in the air means what? You can even try to see, you know, in the air where he is exactly. But I tell you once and once again, MacVittie is not there. So when, if the squad reaches at this, that place to find the criminal, catch hold of this MacVittie, then finally we can see what? They try to search that fellow in the basement area or somewhere, wherever the crime has taken place. The police try to search this fellow, but he is not in the basement, nor even if you try to see in the air, he is nowhere. So the poet T.S. Eliot, he is telling that I will remind you once again and once again that if you try to reach at that place where the crime has taken place, but I'm pretty sure, I'm damn sure that you are not successful, you will not find MacVittie, because he is the mystery cat, because he is the hidden power. Let's see now how he looks, how is his appearance. He says, MacVittie is a ginger cat. Underline the word ginger. Ginger is nothing but the coat or the hair which we can see on the body of a cat. It is in light brownish color, like a ginger plant. So the poet is telling that if you see how MacVittie looks, his body is little brownish in color, ginger type of color. And then he says he is very tall and thin. He is tall and he is very thin. You would know him if you saw him, for his eyes are sunken in. Underline the word know him. Know him means what? To recognize. And then sunken in means what? To set very deep inside. Okay. Some inside the cheeks, we can say. So he says that if you really want to recognize, if you want to know who is MacVittie, I'll tell you how he looks. He has brownish color of skin or the fur or the hair which he has got on his body, as well as he says that you know him very well, because how his eyes are deep sunken inside his cheek. And then he says his brows is deeply lined with thought. Brows is nothing but the eyebrow, as well as deeply lined. Lined means what? There are wrinkles on the brows. And with thoughts, his head is highly domed. Underline the word domed. Domed means nothing but the shape like a dome. Dome like shape. So he says that if you come across this cat, his eyes are very deep. And his eyebrows, it seems it is all the time wrinkled in this way. as if that he is all the time thinking, he has some thought in his mind and he is thinking, probably he is thinking to, you know, do some another crime at some other place. So this is what, his brows are all the time wrinkled as if he is thinking, he is deep set in his own thoughts, his own imagination. And then he says that if you come across his head is like a dome shape. So this shows what, this is the physical appearance, how a cat exactly looks, isn't it? So I'm very sure students, those who have pet as a cat at their home, they know very well how does a cat behave, as well as how does a cat look like exactly, whatever the appearance or the description has been given by the poet, it's somewhat exactly the same. So this is the physical appearance we have seen. Now let's move further. His coat, underline the word coat. Coat means not the exact coat which MacVitie is wearing. Coat is nothing but the body or the fur which we can see on the MacVitie's body. Coat is nothing but the fur, you can write the meaning. Is dusty. Dusty is nothing but the one which is full of dust. From neglect. From neglect means what? The one who has really not thought to clean the body. Neglect is something which is ignored or disregarded. His whiskers are uncombed. Whiskers is nothing but the hair on the body, particularly near the cheek and the nose of any animal. Whiskers, that is the hair. As well as it says, poet says that those are uncombed. Uncombed means what? Which is without, not being combed. So he says that if you come across MacVitie, especially talking about his fur, it is all the time full of dust. It is full of dusty. And why it is dusty? Why it is dirty? Because of the negligence. Why it is negligence? Because this fellow is all the time busy in doing crime or some other place. So the reason it is all neglected from his part, that he doesn't take care much of the care of his body, his fur, his hair, and so it is left uncombed. It's not been combed. He is untidy, probably we can say. And then he sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. Now sway is nothing, underline the word sway, means what? To move. Okay, to move his head from side to side with movements like a snake. So now, if my dear children, if you have seen a snake, how does a snake crawls on the ground? You can see that curly, or you know, the curving movements as that a snake does, isn't it? While going on the ground, running away from, escaping from any place. So it seems to T.S. Eliot that when this cat actually walks, how he walks, he sways, he moves his head side to side like a snake, how a snake walks or crawls probably. And when you think he is half asleep, he is always wide awake. And then he says that if you think, if you come across MacVitie, if you come across this cat, and if you think that he has closed his eyes and he is sleeping, slumber sleep he is having, but it's not like that, but he is wide awake. He is very much attentive. He knows what is going around the world. He is just pretending, he is just enacting, he is trying to make people fool that he is sleeping, but he is not sleeping, but he is very much attentive what is going all around him. And the poet says, MacVitie, MacVitie, there's no one like MacVitie. Again one time he is reminding that MacVitie is of his one kind, there is no another cat like him, for he is a fiend in feline shape, a monster of depravity. Underline the word fiend. Fiend is nothing but a devil. Feline is nothing but the cat species. Now I'll tell you one thing, that if it comes for dog species, we call canine, isn't it? And for when it comes for cat, we call it as in feline. ओके एंड ही एंड अ मॉन्स्टर ऑफ डिप्रेविटी. मॉन्स्टर अगेन अ डेविल. डिप्रेविटी मीन्स अ फेलो हु इज फुल ऑफ इमोरल वैल्यूज, हु डजेंट हैव अ टिंज ऑफ मॉरल वैल्यू, हु ऑलवेज डिसओबे लॉ, और प्रॉबेबली वी कैन सी दैट हु इज फुल ऑफ करप्शन, हु चीट्स एवरीवन, एवरीथिंग, एवरी वेर एवर ही गोज, इजंट इट. सो हियर द पोएट वॉन्ट्स टू टेल वॉट that MacVitie is of his kind because he is a fiend, he is a devil. And how he appears to us? He appears like a cat. Feline shape means nothing but a cat shape. So though he appears us like a cat shape, but he is a devil, he is a monster. And how he is a monster? He is full of depravity, he is full of corruption, moral thoughts, moral values. He doesn't have immoral values, he doesn't have moral tinge of moral value. He keeps on corrupting everyone, he keeps on cheating all the people. So the reason he is one of his kind. And then he says, you may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square. But when a crime is discovered, then MacVitie is not there. So once again, the poet reminds us that if you really want to see, or if you another time, if you come across this cat, you simply can find casually by street. In a by street, is nothing but the parallel street which meets the main street. Or probably we can say the small lanes. Okay, so you can come across this cat some other time in the streets, or you can find him in the square. Square is nothing but the meeting place where the people gather for some talk and then they leave. That's an open area, probably we can say. So here he says that some other time, if you come across this cat, or if you really want to know, you can see him casually in the streets or probably in an open area, that is a square. But one more time, T.S. Eliot makes us reminded that when a crime is discovered, then MacVitie is not there. But whenever there is a crime in any of the area or any of the place, and if you try to search at that time, but you are not able to catch hold of MacVitie, rather you are not even able to see where MacVitie has gone. So this is what beautiful imagination by T.S. Eliot in such a beautiful way. And this is a fictional character, rather not the real one, but the way he has written the poem makes us really imagine or go in that imaginative world and think about the MacVitie cat, his actions, his power of levitation, the law of gravity which is not at all applicable for him. How does he exactly look? I mean, like talking about the way he walks, or the way his fur or his hair are all the time, his whiskers are uncombed, and rather we can see that his eyebrows are all the time full of thoughts, as well as we can see his eyes are deeply set in, his head looks like a dome shape, and it is a bafflement, it is a puzzle, it's a big confusion for whom? For the Scotland people, for the London police probably, as well as the flying squad, who are always ready to reach at the crime place, but unfortunately the effort is gone in vain because they are left with nothing. They are unable to catch hold of this cat whose name is MacVitie, and his another name is Hidden Paw, or he is the mystery cat. So I hope you must have understood the poem, as well as you must have written the difficult word meaning. Thank you for watching.